All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to this Men of Start call. We are so grateful that you've joined us. Wherever it is you are tuning in from the comfort of your home, could be from your car, listening in on your phone. I just want to thank you for carving out a little time in either your night or your morning, wherever it is you're tuning in from, to be with us tonight. We've got literally thousands of people tuning in from all over the place, and we're just so grateful that you've decided to join us. My name is Erik Coover, and with me tonight on the call, I have some incredibly dynamic, empowered, inspired men who are going to be sharing their perspective around this whole Start Your Life movement, the vehicle of Isagenix, and how it's just been such a gift, really, in all of our lives. And I know that we've got people that are tuning in tonight that maybe have no idea what START is, or you may not even know what Isagenix is, and maybe somebody invited you on this call tonight to just feel if this would be a fit for you, and this would be aligned for you. And just to hear from some male perspectives. We know we've got a lot of women on the call as well, but we're really gonna be addressing the male demographic tonight. And then I know we've got some people on the line that are tuning in that have been a part of the Start Your Life movement for, could be a couple weeks, could be, you know, many, many years, and they're building a successful Isagenix business. They're taking the products, and you're just looking for some wisdom, some inspiration tonight from the men that we're going to be hearing from. So wherever it is you're kind of on in your journey, we look forward to kind of bringing you some value tonight and hearing some good stuff. So again, my name's Erik, and I've been a part of this community for a lot of my life. I've been blessed to be around START and around Isagenix for a long time. And, you know, we have a collective vision for the new people on the listening in. Basically, what START is and what it represents, it's a demographic between the ages of 18 to 35 years old. And we have a collective vision amongst this community, and that's what it is. This is a community. And that vision is to ignite all young people around the world to own their lives physically and financially, and through our contributions, create freedom and a lasting legacy. And that vision has just become a magnet that has just rippled across the world, that has attracted so many like-minded, positive, health-conscious people that are just in this to support each other. And, you know, when you're talking about owning your life physically and you're talking about owning your life financially, you can have the greatest intentions in the world, but if you're not like surrounded by a community of empowering people that are like-minded, that are actually going to support you in that journey, you're not going to get very far. I mean, we really are a product of our environments, and, you know, who we hang out with physically, who we hang out with, you know, in our financial circles, usually is a product of kind of where we are in our own life. And so I know that for me personally, as a man, this community has been such a huge blessing in my life in every single way. And what this demographic does is utilizes the vehicle of Isagenix to really achieve this physical, financial, emotional freedom that all of us are really striving for, and we support each other along the way. And so for me personally, I kind of started my Isagenix journey. It was really when I entered college. That's when I got serious about taking these Isagenix products. I quickly understood that, and I'm sure many of you can relate to this, when I moved away from home, I kind of moved away from my foundation for wellness. For growing up until I was 18 years old, I could count on a stocked pantry full of healthy foods that I could go in and reach in. I could count on my mom's home cooking every single night. That was my foundation for wellness. And when I left school, or when I left home and I entered university, like most men, most men's foundation for wellness becomes pizza beer, top ramen, and just a lot of toxic things. And it can be a fun diet. That can, trust me, the pizza and beer diet, don't get me wrong, it can be fun, but it's not conducive to a foundation for long-term well-being and wellness that you can sustain over time. And so that's when I decided to really start taking the Isagenix products. And really, it became my foundation for well-being going through school. I was able to put on more lean muscle mass. I was able to just not worry about gaining, you know, 10, 20, 30 pounds in my first semester of school, which is what many college students face. And it supported me so much just as a young professional in my life, whether I'm traveling, whether I, you know, when I wake up every single day, I just, one thing that's been so consistent in my life, literally over the last 12 years, is the Isagenix products going in my body. And when I was going to school, I quickly realized what a powerful vehicle. I mean, if there's one thing that young people are good at, it's sharing things that we love. And in this day and age, to have a product line that it has literally been a foundation for well-being in my own life for the last 12 years, that I can actually share with other people and earn income from that and, you know, leverage and mobilize an entire demographic of people to share in this vision of the Start Your Life movement and what it can represent for young people. It's been just a remarkable gift. And I think that for me personally, these products have been a huge blessing. The financial opportunity obviously has been huge. But the thing that I value the most over the 12 years that I've been a part of START as a man and within Isagenix is this culture and the community that we have. Before Isagenix and before, you know, START, I was, you know, a very one-dimensional person. I was pursuing a career as an athlete. And like I could be successful in that one thing, but I was behind that one thing. I was very, you know, insecure. I didn't have a lot of confidence. I never in my, like, ever thought I'd be hosting a call with, you know, thousands of people on the line. I just didn't have a lot of self-worth and purpose beyond professional golf, which is what I was pursuing. And so if you were to put me in any other situation besides pursuing professional golf, I'd fall flat on my face because of all the skills and, you know, self-worth that I lacked. And inserting me into this movement, into this culture, because I've been surrounded by so many incredibly, you know, inspiring men and people within this community, it's just like empowered me through every single phase of life that I've been through, through college, through becoming a young professional, through becoming a better husband, becoming a dad of two now. I can always lean on and leverage this community of people that I can count on, that's going to cheer me on, that's going to encourage me to grow and develop. And like all I am today after 12 years of being inserted in this, you know, movement and community is just a product of being in this culture and this community long enough. If you get people into this culture and this community and surround it and that you change people's environments, they just, you can't help but change as a human being, as an individual. And so that's the thing that I'm extremely grateful for, this community of men, this community of people that we have amongst the Start Your Life group. So, and tonight you're going to be hearing from, again, some amazing men who are going to share a little bit about their journey and also how they've been able to kind of start on their pathway and build successful Isagenix businesses. And just know that like this vehicle of Isagenix and this START community, you know, what you put into this is what you're going to get out of it. Many people, you know, are just happy being customers of Isagenix and they're taking the products and they're loving the products and they're happy in that category. And it's acting as a foundation for well-being in their lives. And that's beautiful. It's an amazing thing. But a lot of times people, they start getting great results. They start feeling so much better and they want to share it with other people. And you can start earning an income by doing that. And so what some of the men we're going to be talking to tonight are going to be addressing some different avenues, whether it be social media and branding, whether it be building a legacy for your family, building, you know, this alongside a 9-to-5 job, You know, you can really fit this into the pockets of your life, and you can treat this as a hobby that can pay you an extra, you know, $50 a week or whatever it is, or you can treat it like a full-time business and go all out. And it's got the potential to pay you like a full-time business if you put in the time, the effort, the energy, and build and develop the skills, invest in yourself. You know, this is not something that just happens overnight. You got to invest in yourself. You got to get surrounded by the community. You got to put in the work. And so the first person I get the honor of introducing, he's become a great friend of mine. I've known him for probably like 8 or 9 years now. And when I think about like a man that just inspires me, you know, with the way he is with, you know, in his marriage, the way he is with, you know, he's a new father, just the way he shows up in the world. You know, he's built a very successful Isagenix business. He served on our field advisory board for the entire company of Isagenix. And he's just a great ambassador for what this company stands for, and especially what this young demographic of people and young demographic of men stand for within the STAR community. So James McLeod, I'm going to turn it over to you, my friend.
Wow. Well, Eric, what a tough act to follow. Hello, Isagenix family. My name is James McLeod, and I'm so grateful to follow the ambassador for START and really for Isagenix. And let me just start out by saying, first and foremost, that if you're on this call, and whether you have not yet said yes to Isagenix or you're already part of our Isagenix family, just take a second with me and pause. Because you are incredibly privileged to be on this call tonight. You just are. Now, I know 2020 required so many people to like increase their Zoom calls by like 1,000%. Everybody's Zoomed out and video calls, but this call tonight is special. And let me tell you why. 7 years ago this month, this exact month, Eric said we've known each other for 8 or 9 years. It's getting close to that, but actually 7 years ago, to this very month, almost to the day, was my very first Isagenix event. It was my very first exposure to Isagenix. And I'm gonna get into my story just a little bit, but I allowed myself to get excited, truly excited about what I was hearing from these different testimonies from the people that were up on stage, the people that I was talking to in the hallways. I allowed myself to get really excited. And as a precursor to that, I came into this with an open mind. So whether you're, you know, again, taking a look at Isagenix and seeing if this would be something for you, if you belong here, let me just answer it, you do. Or if you are within Isagenix already and you're saying, hey, I want to take this year to the next level, first we've got to open our minds and we've got to say, okay, maybe we should adapt a new way. Maybe we should allow some new thoughts, new experiences to come in. And so they say that it takes 7 years for your body to fully regenerate cellularly. So now I can actually say that Isagenix is in every single cell of my body because I've been consuming it for 7 years. And so like Eric kind of alluded to, I am married to the beautiful Audrey McLeod and I'm the luckiest man alive for that. But we didn't get started together in Isagenix. I got started at the ripe age of 22 years old and I was in college. And a little backstory about me, I honestly had a pretty bad taste with this industry as a whole. I still to this day believe I was the most skeptical, not just skeptical, but cynical, hateful. I had so much negative energy wrapped around this industry. And the reason I had that, to be just really candid with you, is because I never saw anybody represent it well. To me, it seemed like everybody was trying to put on a face. It seemed like everybody was trying to be more than they actually were. It seemed like there was this incongruency with what I was experiencing versus what they were saying. And for me, it was just a huge turnoff. But I allowed myself to be open to the opportunity of what this could be. I got introduced to it by my little sister. Me and Audrey, my wife, were friends for years and we built separately and then we came together and now we get to build this together every single day, which is a huge blessing. But let me just say, one of the biggest things about this business that I've learned over the 7 years of being a part of it is that it is so much an energetic business. Now, we've just come out of a year and I don't even have to say anything. I can just say that. Everybody knows, okay? So let me just say right here and now, the first start of January, you're privileged to be on this call because now we have a decision to shift our energy. If you're not in a good energetic state, we can get into a good energetic state. If you're in a good energetic state right now, we can up-level it and get you in an even better energetic state. Hopefully by the end of this call, you're going to be so lit up and ready to go share, you know, what this vision, this movement, this opportunity can be about. But this business is energy. This business is all about creating excitement, getting excited about a consumable product that you can, you know, share with your friends virtually or in person and create something that is long lasting. So starting at 22 years old, I was a single guy who was building this in college. I was building it on my college campus, and there was a lot of naysayers. There was a lot of people with opinions, as there are in anything that you pursue. And when, let me just tell you, when you decide to start to grow in your life, not everybody's going to be a fan of that. Okay, I'll just go ahead and warn you. Not everybody's going to be a fan of you taking a step forward this year. But I decided to take a step forward and to further my own future, to go after things that honestly I just wanted. I really desired in my heart to live this life of autonomy, to live this life of, you know, really feeling unbound by, you know, an office or a job, and nothing against jobs or anything like that. But for me, I wanted to be location independent. I wanted to create an income producing asset that would continue long after the initial work that I had put in, you know, it would continue. And so here I am, years later, 7 years later. My wife and I got married 4.5 years ago. We have an 8-week-old son, and we've been able to create a legacy now that I get to show Maverick, my son, you know, how to build not just an income, but to design a life. Going into this next year, what are different areas of your life that you want to design? What are different areas of your life that you want to say, you know what, it would be really great. I would love to, if there was no rules, if we could dream however big we wanted to dream, I would love to be able to take an extra 7 days and go to the beach or go to the mountains or go visit family across the country that we rarely ever get to see. I'd love to be able to go do that. And really the biggest constraints to that are time and money. And I've heard about this network marketing model. I've heard about Isagenix. I've seen the people. I've seen the results. I've seen the community. It all looks incredible, but I've never really counted it for me. What if this year it could be for you? Now, there's any, you know, amount of money that you could make. There's $5,000 that would be so, make such a significant impact in so many people's worlds. And I think initially when people get, you know, intrigued or interested in this industry, they think they got to make 6 figures. They think they got to make 7 figures. You don't have to make that. Because we've all, you know, lived through enough time to where, honestly, when I got started, an extra $150 would change my world. And in fact, it did. And I got a couple product introductory bonuses for sharing this with a couple of friends. And I made $150. And I just about lost it because I had never been paid that much in my life for sharing something. And I got hooked. I saw what this could be. But the beautiful part about not just network marketing, you guys, but Isagenix got it right. Isagenix nailed it. Not only with this product line, it's highly consumable, it's emotional, it's unique, it's the cutting edge of science. We just came out with this brand new collagen elixir that I know everybody is just geeking out about because it tastes phenomenal and it yields results. But also they nailed the financial model, which we're going to get into here in a little bit. The opportunity is just unmatched. And so maybe you're sitting on this line tonight and you're saying, I'd love to have more options. I'd love to be able to make an extra 10,000, 20, you name the number. And Isagenix as a community, as men, as those people who are, whether you're single and you're wanting to lead your own life or you're leading your family and you're wanting to bring in a secondary or third income stream, you can have that here. So for me, the biggest deals when I was building this very young, getting started was it was energetic. I had to get excited. I had to be enthusiastic. Listen, if you're not excited, why would anybody else want what you have? We got to get excited about what it is that this could, you know, be for your life and other people's lives. And so I allowed myself to get excited. Then I really formed relationships and friendships with these other guys in my community, other, you know, who are joining me in this, you know, quest for more, this quest to expand our territory and to really go after something that was attractive in many ways. It is. Residual income is attractive. Looking great and feeling great is attractive. Convenient nutrition is attractive. And let me tell you what, being a part of this community for 7 years, I've never been a part of a more inclusive, a more united community of people, especially men who, when you succeed, they applaud you, they cheer you on, they say, amazing, way to go. You guys know how it is out there. that's not how every environment is. That's not how every business ecosystem is. And in fact, it's in a lot of ways, maybe counter that, where, you know, you're fighting for other people's jobs. So maybe there's a little animosity there. That's not how it works here with Isagenix. There's such a amazing unified front from all areas, from corporate to the field. And it's something that during this time, and the next speaker is about to get into it, we are living in significant times right now within this company. We truly, truly are. If you're taking your first looks at it, you have not missed a boat. In fact, you are right on time. And if you're taking a look at it from a business standpoint, you're already in Isagenix and you're saying, okay, this is go time. Listen, you are right on time. It's time to get to work and help some people. So with that, to bring some clarity to the timing of this, I want to introduce our next speaker, Tyler Walters. He is just a stud of a guy. He's a 3-star Golden Circle, 2-star Crystal executive, and he is down in Tampa, Florida. Now, he's been doing this for 4 years, and Tyler has been doing it full-time for 3 of those. So he knows how to build this business, and he's really excited. Oh, and he also has a very large international presence as well in Asia, which is amazing about this business model that we can build a global business. So with that, Tyler, I'm going to pass it off to you, man.
James, thank you, man. What an honor. I remember getting started. I saw at the top of the start leaderboard under age of 25, James and Audrey McLeod, and I thought there's no way I could ever even be close to those guys. And I just am so grateful for guys like yourself who have paved the way for us, because I know when you got started, there was no young men doing this. And without guys like yourself and Zach Slobin and some of those early inspirations for me, you know, myself, someone like Derek, you're going to hear from in a minute, we probably wouldn't be able to see this for ourselves. So what an incredible opportunity. Hey, I'm a football guy. So in football, there's a saying that win the first quarter, win the fourth quarter. Those are the two most important parts. So I guess we're taking that approach tonight. So we're starting off with Eric and James. We're finishing with Derek and Jake. And, you know, I'm here in the middle, so I'm just going to try to do my best. I'm honored to be on this table with you guys. But let's get into it, guys. I started Isagenix in January of 2017. It's been 4 years since I committed to do this. And the previous year, 2016, was one of the toughest years of my life. So if you're here in January 2021 today, and 2021 was one of the toughest years of your life, which for many of us it might have been, I want to tell you that today you can make a decision that's going to make your life be drastically different. Because on December 31st, 2016, I didn't have a faint dream of what my life could look like, what it does today. But on January, whatever that day was at New Year's kickoff, January 20-something, 2017, I made a decision. And that decision and the involvement in this community with the Start Your Life group and being around this environment, like Eric alluded to, has completely changed my life. So in 2016, I was a collegiate football player, and I had a devastating knee injury that ended my career before I was ready to. Reconstructive surgery, and I fell into a bad trap of hanging with the wrong people, having the wrong habits, drinking too much, eating like crap, making a fool of myself at parties, and was just so lost and looking for direction in my life. And that January, I went to an Isagenix event, and I didn't do it because I had any intentions to join. I was introduced to this by my mother. And, you know, thank you for Eric for making it cool to work with your mom, because until I saw Erik Coover, I didn't know that was a cool thing to do. And my perception of network marketing was not cynical or skeptical like James. Mine was just that it was a thing that moms do. It's a thing that women do. All I'd ever seen my mom do in network marketing and in Isagenix was hang out with other moms. So it wasn't even an opportunity in my head. I just went to this event to support him because I was going to get out of the snow in Ohio for a little bit. And I went to that event. I remember I saw a video on the screen, and some of you guys that have been in Isagenix for a while might remember this video. And it starts off with Jackson Parr from Australia. And he says something like, it's like a beautiful coast somewhere in California or Australia or something. There's like a drone flying. And Jackson's like, all young people, no matter whether from race, age, you know. And I'm like sucked in. And then at the end of that video, Zach Slobin's like, start your life. Come with us. Start your life. And I saw that video and I was like, man, this start your life thing, this is everything I've been looking for. Everything. Because I had gotten into some personal development trying to pull myself out of this rut. And I learned that if you surround yourself with people that have what you want and you find people that are ahead of you that have what you want, if you can just get your ego out of the way and just follow these guys' leads, you can have whatever you want in life. You can have the life that they have. And I saw these guys in this video and then was blessed enough to meet some of them in person at that event. And I said, man, these guys have exactly what I want. I'm getting ready to graduate and start my career in corporate America. I'm dreading going to the office every day. I'm working as an engineer. Can't imagine doing this for 40 years. And I was just desperate. I was listening to podcasts all day, reading books, trying to find some direction. And at that event, when I saw that video, I found that direction. I saw people that had the exact life I wanted. I knew from a young age I wanted to grow up and experience the world. I grew up in a very rural part in the Midwest. And, you know, I knew I wanted to expose myself to diversity, see cool things, travel to places, and work on something that was making an impact. And although I'm so blessed and grateful that I got to start my career as an engineer, it was a great place to start. If you have a great job, you should be grateful for it because it can fund this business. And that job gave me so much, but I never, ever intended to do it for 40 years. And I'm so glad I came across this opportunity. I put my head down with it. And after about a year, I was able to step away. And this opportunity has just opened up so much to me. But I will say this before I move on to what I'm going to talk about, and Eric alluded to it earlier. Despite the income, despite the travels, despite all of it, the thing that is most valuable that I've gained from this company and from this Start Your Life movement is the man I've become. I know that no matter where I got dropped in the world and what happened to me, and this year has been such a great testament to it because there's been so many challenges, but the mindset that I've developed by being around guys like James and Eric and Derek and Jake has changed my entire perspective of the world, and I'm so, so grateful for it. All right, so one thing that I want to talk about today is how to inspire young men to really step into this business, because you know I'm just a business-minded guy. I love reading business books. There's a great book called The Blue Ocean Strategy. If you've never heard of it, you don't need to read the whole book. Just look up like a YouTube summary of it. It's a really cool idea, but it talks about blue oceans versus red oceans. A red ocean is bloody because there's so much competition. So a red ocean would be like trying to open up an Anytime Fitness in your local community right now. There's a lot of competing fitness clubs in your community, right? It's hard, it's competition. Blue ocean is like, you know, when Apple stepped into personal computers and they created a whole new industry and they blew up because it was a blue ocean. It was wide open. Right now with Isagenix, the community of young men, the market of young men is a blue ocean. Even though we have some amazing young men on here, if you go to an event, you're still going to see 75% of the room is women, and God bless them. They're way better at this than all of us, but there is a huge opportunity here. Network marketing traditionally is a business for young men. It wasn't until like 20 or 30 years ago that stay-at-home moms realized they were pretty darn good at this thing. Before that, it was just a bunch of young guys who loved to run around, have fun, work, hustle, and make it happen and build their dreams. And Isagenix has not even scratched the surface of this opportunity yet, and we have all the makings to do it. We have a corporate structure, like bar none, it's the best in the world. And I've seen some cool ones in my travels. I've met people in different companies. There is no better foundation for a young man to build his dreams than this. The products are amazing. The company support is amazing. The opportunity is huge. They pay us on time every Monday. The training is incredible. I mean, there are very few companies in the world where you can hop on a live training like this and hear from some of the top leaders from different teams, and they're working together like this as one team. It's just so unique. So there is no better place to do this. But as far as how do I inspire young men to do this, there's so many other young men out there like me that are just looking for some stinking direction. That's all I wanted. I just wanted someone to come along in my life that was a man that I could look up to as a role model that said, you could do this. You could do something like this. I didn't have anybody like that in my life when I started. I didn't know any men in network marketing. I didn't. And I remember, you know, the first 6 months of my business were a joke. I was trying to kind of do it the way my mom did it. And she taught me so much, but it just wasn't connecting with me because I needed to do it, you know, the way that the young men do. And it was a joke. I didn't treat it like a business. I treated it like a hobby, and it costed me like one. But I remember 6 months into my journey, I was working as an engineer, a civil engineer. If you don't know what that is, we design like roads and sewers and things like this. And, you know, I was all happy. I got my new job, my new cubicle, my salary. I'm out on the big world now. And I got sent in the middle of nowhere, Ohio, to this project. And I drove down there and I got out of my car, and my boss gave me a pair of rubber boots and a flashlight. And I said, what the heck are we doing? I'm supposed to be an engineer. I thought I designed things. He goes down the road. He takes off the manhole, if you know what that is, the big metal circle in the middle of the road. And he says, go down in there and check this out. And I go down and I plop, and I'm in like ankle deep sewage with these rubber boots on. And I remember thinking to myself, like, what am I doing with my life? This is not what I want to do. And that day I was like, I'm not doing this forever. I'm grateful for the job now, but I'm not going to do this forever because I have no desire to be in this sewer right now. But here I am, ankle deep in sewage. And that day I decided that I'm going to make the most of this opportunity. I think there's 2 days in everyone's journey with Isagenix: the day you enroll and the day you decide to go all in. And your all in might look different than mine. Your all in might look like getting an extra $1,000 a month so you can pay off debt, whatever that looks like for you. But there's a day that you decide to join and a day that you decide to go all in. In 2017, at New Year's kickoff, I decided to join. 6 months later, I decided to go all in that sewer. And when I decided to go all in, I just went out and suck knowledge and inspiration from the men that had what I want. Because people on this call right now have what you want, whatever that is you're looking for, and you just need to listen to them. So that night I downloaded podcasts, I downloaded audiobooks, I started listening. I looked up the Start top income earners and I followed every one of them on there. And James was number one. I followed every man I could find on that call. What are these guys doing? What are they posting? What are they doing? I message them. people are gracious. You know, James has been so gracious in his journey to help me along the way. People have what you want, find them and ask good questions. Ask better questions, get better results. All right, and to wrap up, guys, I just want to talk for 1 second on why, what James talked about, why now is the time, man, because it really, really is. You know, James was started in Isagenix during a great phase of growth in the company 7 years ago. And, you know, he knows as well as anybody that these last few years, we've been innovating and grinding and looking for that next big breakthrough. And it's here. And if you are just getting started, you don't even know what I'm talking about. You're just getting started at the right time. If you got started a while ago, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But the culmination of three things in my mind have this company ready to explode and go next level. The first is the product innovation. It's unbelievable. I'm so hooked on the Bia in the last year. I mean, I drink like 3 a day now. All right. And this collagen thing, I've never had a skincare routine. I don't even usually wash my face before I go to bed tonight, but I'm fired up about it because everybody else is fired up about it. And I see how many people are ordering it. You know, the product innovation is crazy. We're coming out with stuff that's unique that people can't buy anywhere else. The second is the technology. This Penny app, I'm telling you, I got people in Taiwan joining our team just because of Penny. As soon as I show them that, they don't want to see the products. They don't want to see the company. They don't want to hear anything else. They're like, this Penny thing is amazing. It's got artificial intelligence. Your social media is all hooked up. You're connecting. Our technology is going next level, and it's making this business so easy for people like myself. When I got started, to have a full-time job that's very demanding, to be very efficient with our time. This business is meant to be built in the pockets of your time part-time, and our technology is making that easier and easier. And the third and final reason is the expansion this company is doing globally. You know, we just doubled our international footprint, guys. If you guys understand network marketing and business, this is when companies explode. We have a company that is one of the biggest in the US. And if you didn't watch it, go to the New Year's kickoff breakout session and watch the building internationally. They did an unbelievable job with it. And on that, we saw that, I don't remember the exact stats, but it's something like 75% of most network marketing business comes internationally outside of the US. And for Isagenix, it's only like 30% right now. What does that tell me? That tells me blue ocean. I love to travel. It's my drug of choice. I go anywhere, anytime. I love it. And everywhere I go, I'm always working the business. I'm telling you, I don't ever meet anyone outside of the US that has ever heard of Isagenix before. What an opportunity. So congratulations to you for saying yes to this opportunity. If you're on day one or week one, maybe you've made that first decision to join, congratulations. That's the first decision. Maybe today is that day for you, like it was for me in that hot summer of 2017 in that sewer, where you make that second decision to go all in. And if you've already made both decisions, just keep your head down and keep chugging, guys. It's going to be a heck of a ride these next 1 to 2 years. Can't wait to see us all where we're at in 2 or 3 years from now. Let's just keep getting more and more of these young guys in there. All right. Thanks, guys. I'm going to turn it over next to Derek Hightower, my man. I met him at an event a couple years ago. He loved to talk hoops and football. He's an athletic guy himself and a heck of an ambassador of what START means. He's a living, breathing START ambassador. So the way he carries himself, his health, his wellness, his energy, his charisma. And he's down in Kansas City. He's a computer engineer full-time who's been able to build a crystal executive in his part-time hours with this business and is crushing it. And can't wait to hear what he has to share with us. So let's go, Derek.
I appreciate that, Tyler. I appreciate that. Yeah, we've got, you know, the engineer thing going on and you being a, you know, an athlete, which whenever we met, I was like, oh, Tyler, you know, like that person you can really connect with. And so I appreciate everybody on this call, everybody on the panel. Fellas, what's up? This is, I finally feel like the majority. I know there's some ladies out there, but tonight's men's night. So this is really awesome. So I'm getting straight to it. My story, 31 years old. I live in Kansas City, huge Chiefs fan, and married to my smarter half, Melissa, former college football athlete myself, started about 4 years ago, just looking for a solid solution. That's really what it was when it came to performance. I was, you know, just tired of, I was actually tired of just searching from one place to another. Probably a lot of you can relate, just tired of searching from one thing to another, going to store when it came to, you know, just products, when it came to performance. And, you know, I would always end up rotating things. And me being, you know, kind of like having that athletic background, I just want something that I know can be my go-to. And I don't even want to think about it. I just know that it works. And that's what Isagenix ended up being for me. And, you know, I found you know, once I actually immersed myself in Isagenix, it was so much more. This community, this start community, it's really been everything. Now, I'm not going to lie to you, I wasn't skeptical of Isagenix at all. For one, because, you know, I tried everything under the sun when it came to, you know, performance products. And then, of course, I then found out that I could generate some income. So I definitely wasn't skeptical. So I currently have, you know, a day job as an IT professional, as an engineer. It started as something I was, you know, once super fulfilled, but, you know, as all these guys are relating to, you know, talking about and kind of hit on, you know, you kind of immerse yourself into this community and kind of dig into Isagenix, and, you know, you meet guys like Tyler and Jake, you know, Eric and James, and you're like, you know, you just think about more and what could be and what can be. So, I mean, what I'm going to be talking about is, you know, running this business with 9 to 5. You know, I typically find out that there's typically 3 people that I talk to and usually run into the most. For one, you know, the ones with, you know, a day job that aren't open to building an additional income stream for whatever reason. And that's totally okay. It's totally okay. But they also make it known and, you know, they wish for more time and money. 2, there's the ones with the day job that also know the importance of building another income source and, you know, eventually want to create more time and money. And then 3, there's the ones who, you know, want to drop everything right now, their day job, whatever that may be, and they want to continue building their network marketing business right now. You know, and for those that fall into 1, you know, if they aren't open, you know, you're talking to people, they aren't open to, you know, our opportunity, that's totally fine. But don't beat yourself up about it, because you're just gonna burn yourself out. Your family, friends, you know, it can become personal. You might feel like it can become personal at some time, but don't beat yourself up about it, because it's not, you know, it's not your duty to force anyone to take a look. And if you fall into 3, no one can tell you, you know, when the right time is for you. Everyone's situation is totally different. And, you know, bills, family, whatever it may be, just make sure you have a plan and don't put yourself in a rock and a hard place. But for those that find themselves in 2, this is where Isagenix is the Patrick Mahomes, the LeBron James, the GOAT. This is truly where it is, because, you know, if you have a 9-to-5 and you're open to wanting to build this business like a lot of you are, on this call, you can earn while you grow. Like, literally, it doesn't, you know, for some, it doesn't have to be big money or bust. Like, it just doesn't. Whether it's $100 a week, an extra $100 a month, whatever it is, it doesn't have to be big money or bust. Some is better, $100 a week, $100 a month is better than zero. I can tell you that, it's just better than zero. I can work with $100 a week, $100 a month. I can't work with zero, you know, especially, you know, if you're wanting to build this to maybe provide for bills or, you know, get rid of debt, whatever it may be. You know, just being able to tap into that creativity mindset over, you know, and leave that kind of employee mindset behind, and, you know, being able to tap into your creative side is something that is just so refreshing. And that's what I found it for me personally. It's just so refreshing to be able to tap into that creativity side. You know, all while being able to leverage your time. You know, Tyler talked about this, you know, the resources that we have, you know, your team, these calls. I mean, come on, like, it's no cost to you. And you just are learning while you earn while you grow. You know, that's the awesome thing about this. You know, my wife and I, just like everyone else, I'm sure we're not the only ones in the world, we went through a rough patch last year. That's just what it is. You know, unfortunately, her income was cut short. But because we made the decision to build this, you know, on the side as well as my full-time income, you know, we were able to support ourselves and to fill gaps throughout the whole year, you know. And like, you just don't know, you really don't. And of course, we didn't know you know, 2020 was coming, but we were able to fill those gaps and get through, you know, the year because of Isagenix supporting that. You know, maybe some of you on this call experienced the same and right now are looking, you know, forward to say, hey, I need a plan to make sure that, you know, when times get rough, I can fill a gap. And, you know, you found a home. You found people that are looking for the same exact things that you are. And if they're not here already, there are plenty that are out there looking and searching for ways right now. You know, a lot of people say if they're not going to hear from you, they're going to hear from somebody else, you know, when it comes to Isagenix. And that's the truth. You know, so for example, you know, my wife and I, we sat down and we said, okay, you know, let's think about a goal. You know, we want to earn a certain amount of money when it comes to our ISA business that will, you know, pay for our bills, including our mortgage. And then that would allow me to be able to, you know, with my income and anything that she's able to earn this year, you know, because again, things are up and down when it comes to get back to normal. We will take that and that would pay for groceries, you know, home improvement projects that we want to do, you know, investing, play money. So use your 9-to-5 job as a crutch, because that's what it is. Like, it's a crutch. And, you know, Tyler was talking about this earlier with Penny, you know, well, I don't have time to, you know, I don't have any free time for my health. I don't have any free time to build a business on the side. Well, for one, there's a plug for the products, you know, because it literally, you know, at the snap of a finger, you can have a meal or whatever, you know, wherever the case may be. But when it comes to, you know, being in a crunch, when it comes to your, you know, building a business, Penny is a game changer. I mean, literally, kids, job, whatever. Penny is the excuse breaker, if you will, for not having, you know, for not, you know, for saying that you don't have, you know, enough time to build your business. We all know the importance of, you know, events. For me personally, they're non-negotiable just because the self-development, your self-development is so important. Just building your belief, not only in the company and the products, but, you know, in the business and you know, just getting that confidence when it comes to the daily life of, you know, building your Isagenix business. Some of you may have, you know, certain things that you're not comfortable with, but you tap into these vents and it's just like you grow. And, you know, so you may say, you know, my job doesn't allow me to attend these events. Well, it's 2021. Things are virtual. So what does that mean? Well, they're recorded. They're recorded. So, you know, whenever I think about, you know, being recorded, take advantage of the recordings. You know, you'll know how much you really care about your business and want to build your business if you will tap into the recordings. It's just plain and simple. You'll know how important it is if you tap into these recordings, because they're always going to be there for you. So again, you know, something is always better than nothing, especially in this case. So I want to go ahead and pass this on to my man, Jake. You know, he's going to bring us all the good value when it comes to social media branding. And he's been in the company for 1 year, executive. With his branding skills, I'm ready to, you know, I got my pen and paper ready to take some notes. So Jake, go ahead and hit him with that goodness.
Let's go. Come on now. I know you guys are all listening right now. We're at the home stretch. And first of all, thank you so much for that, Derek, and for James and Tyler bringing the heat. And you guys are probably sitting there right now. You're in your car like Eric said earlier, I don't know where you are, but we need to get a state change. Because if you guys want to take in what I'm about to share, and not only take in, but hold in what you've learned from these men before here, then right now at where you're at, if you're driving, please do not do this. I need everyone to reach up, take a deep breath in and sigh. Let's go to the left, take a deep breath in. We're changing that state and sigh, and last to the right. Come on now. I know you guys are thinking you're too cool. Get that stretch in And come on, you got to stretch it out. You got to get into a state, because if you are building a brand right now, you have to understand you have to show up every single day, because you are the walking billboard. And that is the most beautiful thing. And so before I get into any further, I want to ask a couple questions here. And yes, I know we're all on this Zoom right now. I know that I'm not able to see you, but I'm speaking to you. If you're there with your kids, with your family, maybe you're still driving because you are coming home from your 9-to-5, like Derek just shared about, this is for you. You know, when was the last time that you were wanting to make that post about this? Maybe because you've been in Isagenix, but you've been struggling about how to post about it, because you don't want to come off salesy or come off as that typical network marketing person. When was that? Or what about the time where you wanted to tell someone about what you're doing when you met them in person, you know, obviously with proper social distancing in the time we are today, but you were so nervous and you didn't know how to brand yourself or share what you did, that you just said the easy answer of like, oh, you know, I just help people, or you just shared your other job, even though that's the least passionate thing you're about. And that's why you're in Isagenix right now, because you want that energy, right? This is what this is about. And in these next 10 or so minutes, I'm going to share with you how to brand effectively in your network marketing business, whether you are just starting today and your friend told you to get on this call, or you've been at this for years and years like James. Right? We all have our different stories in here, but we all have to understand how to brand ourselves, because our brand is like a company culture. Just like how Isagenix has its company culture, that's the reason why I'm in here today. And I'll tell you about that in a second. But it takes years and years to build the brand, the culture, which is like growing a forest. But just as long as it takes that long to build the forest and to grow it, it just takes one fire, one match, one thing that you do wrong, you post, it could completely bring everything down. And I don't share that to scare you. I share that because it shows how powerful it is that every day matters. Every day matters. And you guys are walking billboards, and you are not a walking billboard for Isagenix. You are a walking billboard for you. And Isagenix is the vehicle that takes you to new stratospheres. That's how cool it is to have a brand that you create. So a little bit about me is that I'm right about my 1 year anniversary with Isagenix. And it's pretty wild to think about this. And what better of time to come in during this whole 2020 where things just went crazy, but we had this beautiful company that got to take care of us and still run optimally and grow into new levels when everything else was shutting down. And see, just 3 years ago, and I really resonate with what Tyler shared earlier, maybe you guys could resonate with this too. Where were you 3 years ago? What were you thinking? Just like how Tyler, you know, shared, he was like, I couldn't even imagine what I'm doing today. And 3 years ago, I just got out of college, leaving my nursing job because I was getting pulled at this idea of being a nurse, but it didn't make me feel alive. I was just going through the motions. And so I actually left my nursing job to chase my passions of being a trainer. So if there's trainers out there right now, there is hope. You can have more time in your life. You don't have to keep trading time for money, right? And I was a trainer, and I couldn't even imagine. I had big hopes in my life, but I couldn't even imagine where I'm at today. And now 3 years later from that point, I went from being a personal trainer in Maui, Hawaii, where I grew up. And now I'm, you know, working with small business owners and Fortune 500 CEOs and even some of Tony Robbins' speakers. And I was a nurse helping them in their business and such. And I share this because this is all possible for you too, because it's about your brand. And the dilemma that I had was I was working with all these clientele, and I was like, I was so protective of my brand because I was working with these people. I didn't want to ruin the integrity, right? Who can relate? You don't want to ruin that integrity. You don't want to be that person. You don't want to be, oh, they're going to try and sell me some products right? Oh, it's like Tyler once again said, this is like what my mom did, or my friends in high school did that. And they were like, it was like a pyramid scheme and all this crazy stuff that you hear all these things. And to be honest, I didn't even know what network marketing was. And what happened in my story that changed it is actually my own head coach that was working in my company was told me about it, the closest person to me. And I told her no for 3 months, four different times. But I am so grateful that she came up to me that fourth time, because that's where I saw nothing that I wanted to do was working. I was like, let me see what this is. And I got on a call. I saw it was real. No smoke and mirrors. You're in here for a reason. Just like how James said, you are on this call for a reason. And I'm going to make sure that you leave this call feeling more equipped in your branding, because what happened is I saw it was aligned with my brand and I didn't have to conform to Isagenix. I could allow Isagenix to conform to my brand and allow me to elevate to help more people. That's the difference maker that really stood out. I was like, whoa. I was like, I don't have to make posts once a week. I don't have to, you know, share these products and buy a bunch of it to give to my friends out of my trunk. I was like, this is pretty cool. So as it goes on and goes on and goes on, you will learn about branding. I'm sure a lot of you probably, once you signed up, saw a lot of friends, you know, make fun of you or say, well, you're now part of that, or you've gone to the dark side, or whatever the case is. I'll tell you, we've gone through that too. I've gone through it. But the things that pull me through, and if you don't have a pen and paper yet, I'm going to help you on how to do your branding right. But the three things that really pulled me through are three virtues to effective branding. Three virtues. Now, you've probably heard of values, but I'm going to tell you a little difference of the values versus the virtues. So once again, if you don't have a pen and paper, or if you're driving on the road, hey, this might be worth it to pull on the side and take some notes for a couple minutes. Or we do have the recording, because we are in 2021. You can listen to the recording. But the difference between a value and a virtue, especially if you're trying to be a brand, don't forget you're a company. You are in this business for yourself, but you're not by yourself. You are a company. And if you're a company, the companies that are successful, just like Isagenix, have values. And they hold true to it. And everyone that comes into this company has that. So you need your values. But even more, I'm going to give you virtues. Values are a set of beliefs, which is great. However, virtues are a set of actions that you act upon on. So if you have these three virtues in your branding, you're going to start to see more actions happen in your life. Because too many people are talking the talk right now, but don't walk the walk. I want you leaving this call walking the walk. So virtue number one is about state. Okay. I'm going to tell you what it is in a second, but it's about your state. Virtue number two is about your belief. And virtue number three is about the content you create. And if any of you are familiar with Tony Robbins, and all his trainings, you know, number one peak performance business strategist in the world, he talks about this thing called the triad. And the triad determines your destiny. If you can control your triad, you can control your life in every single situation. And what is that? Well, it's your physiology, which is your state. It's the language you say to yourself or to others, which we'll put in a branding perspective, which is your content. And your belief is the meaning behind you put everything, right? If you just joined Isagenix, you can either believe it's the end of your social life or it's the start of something exciting. If you just, ended a relationship, that could be the greatest thing or the worst thing, right? That's your belief. So these virtues, you're going to follow them here. And I'd suggest writing them down, because this is going to help you every single day be able to brand yourself. And let's start off with the state. The state that I bring, and I'm just pulling up my notes here, is the state I show up daily is of my highest self and for the greatest good of others. Let me repeat that. This is a virtue. The state I show up daily is of my highest self and for the goodness of others. That means every day you show up, whether you're showing up to your family, you're showing up on a business call, an opportunity because you're meeting people in person again, you're showing up on Instagram Live, Facebook Live, stories, whatever it is, you're showing up in your peak optimal, highest self. Because if you're going to brand yourself as someone that's maybe a trainer, that's, you know, already super fit, but maybe you're a stay-at-home dad and you're trying to talk to other dads out there, what better than, like all our men here talked about tonight, to have energy that other dads wish they had? That they see you in this highest state when you're making a post, you know, with your kid, and they see you just even through the words, they feel the energy, they hear it. They're going to want to know what you're doing. So this sounds so monotonous. You probably heard, have a morning routine, have, you know, time for yourself, go get your work, all those things. But those things get you into a state, because when you do that, you start to create so much more momentum. You guys follow me right now? If you're listening around, just give me a head nod. I know I can't see that, but I just want you guys to be physically there with me. The state is huge. Now, the second virtue is all about the belief. And I'm going to say this one twice. The belief I instill is serving the individual before the group. The belief I instill is serving the individual before the group. Now, you might have not heard of that one before, but what does that mean? Well, let me tell you this, and let me ask you this. When you were scrolling through Instagram and you saw maybe an influencer or another person you look up to talk, right away through their content, which we'll talk about in a second, did you feel like you were personally connected with? Did you feel like they were talking to you or to a general audience? And if they were talking to a general audience, because you've maybe had a time in the past, how did that make you feel? Did you really feel like you were getting talked to or heard? Probably not. And the problem that people have a lot with branding is that they try to always scale, get so big that they're on stages of 12,000, but they forget that they're talking to that one person in the very back of the room that is on their phone, that's distracting themselves, that is having a terrible life, and they wish that they could have a change, but they don't. But you speak exactly to them. And because you speak exactly to them and instill belief that it's possible for them, guess what? All 11,999 people in that room will also believe it. But when you make this content and you instill belief, when you're on a call right now, I'm speaking to you directly. I'm not speaking to you like there's thousands of people watching this, because there probably is right now. There's a lot of hungry men right now that want to make network marketing, make Isagenix successful. There's a lot of even women on here that are probably trying to get their men involved, or is just on here because they want so much inspiration. But I'm talking to you exactly right now. And I'm letting you know that these three virtues can truly change your life. And it starts by instilling belief that it is possible for you. Just like how it was possible for me a year ago when I said no to it 4 times. I know a lot of people that said no to it 40 times. It's crazy, right? And the third value, or the third virtue, is all about the content. And this is where it gets exciting. I'm going to share a little more of the exercise we're going to do. The content I create is made to entertain, inspire, and educate. The content I create is made to entertain, inspire, and educate. That is a virtue you live by every single day, because no matter, like I said, you're making content anywhere or you're just talking to people, there's a triad of a successful post. There's a triad of successful marketing. It's entertainment, inspiration, and information. There will be some posts you talk about Isagenix, and it's going to be straight information. It's going to be the release of the new collagen elixir, which, just like you, James, I am pumped about it. I'm taking it twice a day. I don't care if this is skincare and women think it's only for that. I'm like, I want to get a glow on. I want to have better skin. You know, my hands got calluses from lifting weights. I was like, I'm not going to lose those calluses, but they're going to get a little softer. But that's straight information. I'm sharing all about the quality of it, right? A post and a content about education, education, a post about inspiration could be either about Isagenix Or it could be about something that you're inspirational. If you're a trainer, you're a gym owner, you're in the financial world, you can bring inspiration about money, how you help people in some way. You can bring inspiration about how your kid just started walking and, you know, you've helped them after they fell 100 times. I think sometimes we forget too that, hey, we're just kids trying to walk here in Isagenix. And if we told our kid to stop trying after he kept falling and falling, that just wouldn't make sense. So stop beating yourself up. And then the last of that content triad is the entertainment. And there's a lot of guys on here right now that are pretty good at entertainment. I know, I think, once again, I've been watching all your guys' stories here, and James is so good at entertainment. Even Eric is like, James has his little baby in his hands, drinking the collagen elixir, and he's trying to catch his child sneezing. And as random that is, and you're like, well, that's not related to Isagenix, that is entertainment. And when you live by this virtue, and when you hit all three of those at the same time, when you have your kid sneezing in your hand, while you're sharing that there's 5 grams of marine collagen, and you're being inspiring because you're at home working, you have created a successful brand. So remember, number one is your state. Number two is your belief. And number three is the content. These are the three virtues to effective branding. And as we wrap up here, I hope this resonates with you guys alone. There's no secret master formula that's going to make you an effective brand. And it doesn't happen overnight. It's going to take a lot of no's. It's going to take a lot of humiliation. It's going to take a lot of people saying not now. It's going to take some people saying, oh yeah, I'm all in, but then they quit a couple weeks later. It's going to take the consistency and the persistency of you following your virtues. And so this last exercise, this is where you need that pen and paper, is I understand a lot of us, especially us men, we have multiple areas of passion, either avenues of our jobs, and we're not just doing Isagenix by itself. Not like Tyler until he made a decision 6 months in, you know, James took a while, Eric was doing it through college, you know, Derek's still doing it through his 9-to-5. I still have my business. And what I want to do is I want you to write out right now your top, if you have multiple, keep it to 5, but if not, write out all your, it doesn't have to be ranked, all your passions and your avenues of business. Just write it out right now. So, you know, if you are into hunting, put it on there. If you are into, you know, if you have a financial job, if you have other side hustles, if you are still a 9-to-5, write those out. And what I want you to do next to each one is I want you to, out of 100%, what out of those areas do you share on social media right now? What do you share on social media right now, those areas? So hunting. Well, I post about hunting literally every single day. So that's a high percentage. I share my trophies and I let people know that I am out there, you know, feeding my family, right? But you could also put, even for Isagenix, how much are you sharing it? There's no right or wrong answer, but you have to see what those percentages are, okay? If you have a 9-to-5 business that maybe you are a trainer or such, and you're sharing a lot of that, but not of Isagenix, you might start seeing the problem here. And after you see that percentage balance, the last thing I want you to do, because this is gonna be very important for branding, because clarity is power, is that you have to put the percentages of what you want to share on your social media in your most ideal sense. Because you'll first get clarity seeing those percentages, seeing, oh my gosh, I really am sharing a lot about, you know, that, or my husband and wife, we always share every time we go out to dinner and it's like a little much, you know, but I'll tell you right now, it's okay to be normal. It's okay to have a normal life. And it's okay to have Isagenix balanced in with your day-to-day living, because that's what branding is. So I'll leave you guys with this. Go out there and just look at yourself in the mirror and look at yourself and say, if someone was looking at me right now, what would they think? What would they see me as? Would they want to listen to me? And if they do, fantastic. If not, I suggest start following these virtues and start changing your brand so you can go be a successful man in Isagenix. I want to thank you guys here. I want to introduce one more time. We have the man, the myth, the legend. We have Erik Coover to wrap it up here and to even maybe have some questions. So thank you guys for your time.
Hey, Jakes, thank you so much, man. Great, great stuff from everybody. Just what a, I mean, just listening to everyone tonight on the call just, you know, has me so re-inspired just, and just reconfirms what incredible men we have a part of this community of Start in Isagenix. My phone's been going crazy just through the chat and also getting texts saying how valuable everybody's been. I know there's been lots of questions. One of the things that's been common in this call is that, like, can we please do this again? So instead of going off and doing some questions tonight, what I want to actually do is actually commit that we are going to do this Men of Start call 100%. We're going to do it again. We'll figure out kind of the consistency of it, but we've obviously got so many incredible men within Isagenix, within this community of Start that I know want to share their gifts and wisdom as well. And we can take some of those questions on a future call. So I want to respect everybody's time and just thank you so much. Wherever you're tuning in from, whether you're new to Start, whether you've been in Isagenix for some time, thank you so much for joining us tonight. Thanks so much, everybody. Have a great night.